Sister Brittany was going to sing, but if she could wait to next week, would that be all right? Okay. Praise God. Let's give God some praise, somebody. It's something that's hit my heart a little bit. Y'all might have to bear with me because y'all know that God deals with me in strange ways sometimes. I try to write. I try to do this. I try to do that. I told him this morning I had about 6 pages of notes. Come on, somebody. And I had it all together. And what happened? The same thing every time. I get here and the studies I had, they do me some good. But I don't have the paper with me. I don't know how to keep a notebook, a tablet, and this and that. It's kind of hard for me to do. Amen. But Deacon got me something different. I can keep something like that. But even in that, I guess I got to learn how to do things differently. All right? Amen. But it's something that God gave me. It's kind of strange. I'm going to try to see how it's going to work out. Somebody just look toward heaven and say, work it out.
Work it out.
All right, if you'll stand for the reading of the word, I'm going to read one little verse. And maybe we can get something out of it. I'm going to try to see what we can do. I wish I could preach. But 2 Corinthians 5 and 15 said, and that he died for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto him which died for them and rose again. May God add a blessing to the reading and the hearers of his word. Heavenly Father God, we come to you once again in the name of Jesus, thanking you for your goodness, your mercy, your love, and your kindness. Once again, Lord, these are your people. They don't belong to me. Nothing I can give them, nothing I can do for them that can help them unless you give it to me. And I'm asking, Lord, that in these few moments that you would just word my mouth, strengthen me to preach the gospel. In Jesus' name we pray and we thank you. Amen.
Amen.
All right. I was dealing with two different subjects. And I guess I'm going to put it together and see if it makes any sense. Sometimes it looked like the thing pastors say don't make sense. And then when you sit down and think about it, you say, oh, I got it. That makes a little bit of sense there. But I've been thinking and dealing with the blood.
All right now. Oh, yeah. You have to preach that now.
And see, I don't want to mess with that because when you talk about blood, you're right. You have to preach. And another thing I was thinking about was seeds. Blood and seeds. So if I were to take, which I usually turn around and wait till the end to give you a title because God in heaven given me this and then it hit me, this is what I'm dealing with. Now here we go. But if I take for a title today, I would say blood seed.
All right.
Y'all catching that?
All right.
I think I'm catching it right now. And when you deal with a seed, y'all catch this. This is really good to me. I looked up the definition. A seed is the part of the plant containing the embryo from which a new part can grow. Are y'all hearing this? A seed is the very source of any and everything. Look at your neighbor and tell them everything starts with a seed. So there are many different seeds that we plant. Come on, somebody. We're always planting seeds. Every time you open your mouth, you're planting a seed.
That's right.
Every time you look a certain way, you're planting a seed.
You're right.
Your body gestures and movements and this and that, you plant seeds with them. Come on, somebody. Somebody can look at you and you're planting a seed, amen, by just moving a certain way when they walk past. And the way you move plants a seed in them to tell them that you don't like them. Are y'all catching this? Oh, help me today, Jesus. The way you look when she walked by, y'all ain't hearing me.
He plants a seed to show that you are a whoremonger. Lord, help me today. Y'all don't like, but I talk for real. I'm going to teach you the right thing. The way that you sit up and you do the basic instinct. Let them know that you're planting a seed that you hot in the behind. Y'all ain't hearing me. And somebody has to be a little older to know basic instinct. Hallelujah. Showing things that you ain't got no business. For those that's old enough to understand. Hallelujah. But it is a part of a plant containing the embryo. Woo, help me, Jesus. Oh, Lord, help me today. And when you look at a seed, I want to put it this way. You can see with your natural eye an apple orchard. Amen? Can you not? You look out, you'll see nothing but trees. But when you take that little bitty seed out of the midst of an apple, out of that core, you cannot see at time that the orchard lies within the seed. Y'all didn't catch that, did you? But it's in the midst of that seed. Somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
A seed is round. Just as a woman that is about to deliver. Oh, y'all ain't hearing me today. About to deliver. So a seed is pregnant with all types of potential.
Amen.
Y'all don't hear me today.
Right.
A seed is pregnant with potential. Woo, Lord. If you plant the right seed, you can plant anything you want into somebody.
That's right. Amen.
Oh, but you got to know that that somebody has to be receptive. It has to be good ground in which you are planting that seed on. Woo, I wish I could preach today. Y'all gonna get bored with this here today. But this is what God is dealing with me on today. Somebody say blood seed. Woo. In order for something to live, something else has to die. Hallelujah. When you deal with that seed from that core of the apple, that apple is disconnected from the tree. I don't hear nobody. And when it's disconnected, oh my God, y'all don't hear me. That thing will wither up, it will rot, and it, oh, y'all don't hear me, because it's dead. That's why you got to eat it while it's good. I don't hear nobody. Oh, you can't go back to it later, boy. You better watch yourself. And then you take the seed from it and plant it. Oh, help me, Jesus. Then you can have a great apple orchard. And I want you to understand this, and then I'm going to go on with this, because now I'm starting to feel the Holy Ghost anointing. I don't hear nobody. But I heard one preacher preaching, and he began to talk, a teacher talking rather, and that teacher said, oh, my grandfather planted apple trees. He had seeds at one time when I was a little bitty boy. It was an old man. And he said, when he had those seeds from that apple, he planted it. And when he planted it, come on somebody, amen, he said that later on his grandchildren are now jumping around, climbing on that apple tree. So I want you to understand this, and y'all please catch this with wisdom, amen, that to plant a seed only takes a moment. But the fruit thereof lasts a lifetime. Are y'all catching this? Woo! So it takes a moment to plant that seed. But that seed that you plant will bless your children and your children's children and your children's children's children. I don't hear nobody. But it goes on and on if you plant that right seed. Somebody shout, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Now I want to talk about the blood.
Talk about that blood.
Woo! I'm fixing to preach right now. Help me today. help me with this a little bit. But blood supplies oxygen.
Oh, yeah.
Without blood, you can't breathe. I don't get nobody.
That's all right.
The blood removes the waste from the body.
Oh, yeah.
Woo! Some blood cells clean out the mess in other blood cells. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
All right.
And the blood also regulates the body temperature.
All right.
Woo! I've been dealing with high blood pressure, Sister Niecy. So I know that if the blood pressure gets too high, it'll drive you crazy. Y'all ain't gonna catch this one too good. Y'all gonna catch this one when you go home. But if you get too low, you're in a messed up position too. Come on, somebody. Y'all all miss it. All right, somebody call it. Hallelujah. But we have to have the blood in order to live today. Somebody shout, yes, Lord. Loses blood, it loses life.
Oh God.
Yes,
that's right.
You're right.
And it comes to a point that we are going to have a blood transfusion.
Watch out.
Y'all ain't hearing me today. I feel like preaching right now. Are y'all catching this? No. You better cut it out. Shut your mouth.
Right.
Hallelujah. Yes. But somebody say, blood seed. Because I'm not just talking about natural blood. Yes, Lord. When you deal with the blood of Jesus, somebody shout yes. He had to be stabbed in the side. He had to have thorns put in his head. He had to be whipped 39 times. He had to have the blood streaming down. Now, I don't hear nobody in order for us to live. Something had to die. But when we look at the scripture today, it said, and he that died for all. Oh, I don't hear nobody. He died that they which live shall not henceforth live to themselves, but live for Jesus. He gave his life for you. So why not give your life for him? Service, because he said that it's at a point in time where people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. Somebody shout, yes, Lord. I wish I could preach to me. Somebody shout, yes. Hallelujah. And when I told you that the seed is as a pregnant woman, you must understand that even when we talk about death, that childbirth is the closest that any woman ever comes to death. I don't hear nobody, but when that which is coming out comes out, amen, they forget all about the pain. Oh, y'all ain't hearing me today. While they going through, they say, this will never happen again. I will never in my life do this again. But when they look at me in the eye, oh, I don't hear nobody.
me. Somebody show me this. Yes!
I'm trying to calm down. I wanted to just, y'all sit down, sit down, sit down. Oh, y'all ain't hear me today. Are you hearing me? Am I making it clear or am I hollering too much? I want you to hear me. The blood. The blood, the blood, the blood. Come on, somebody. He did not shed his blood in vain. And if we take, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, take what God has given us and use it. Take advantage of the opportunity. Come on, somebody, that God has given us to take in his blood. The more blood, the more power. I don't hear nobody. Make me think about Willie James Campbell. He said, Lord, send your blood. Lord, buckets of blood. Come on, somebody, buckets and buckets and buckets of blood. Pour your blood on me. Come on, somebody, drench me. And oh, God, I don't hear nobody. Oh, and it's a never-ending fountain. The blood, the blood, the blood. And it was written that when I see the blood, the death angel will pass over. Somebody shout, yes, Lord. I'm talking about the power in the blood. That's why they used to take that blood and put it on the doorposts. I don't hear nobody. They would put the blood on the windowsills. Because nothing can come in, nothing can conquer, nothing can come through, nothing can fight, nothing can battle, nothing can win, nothing can compete against the blood. Come on, somebody, I don't give a nothing. He said, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And that is the revelation knowledge of God. I don't give nobody. And in that revelation, we know that it all came through the blood. I wish I could preach y'all. I wish I could preach. But it all came through the blood. And I'm taking advantage of this opportunity. Lord, cover me with your blood. Cover my mind. Put it on my heart. Come on, somebody, on my hands. Oh, I can't see right. Come on, put your blood on my mind. Oh, I want to talk right. Put your blood on my tongue. Oh, I don't hear nobody. Cover my feet with your blood. So I walk the right way. I don't hear nobody. Hallelujah. Cover my body with your blood. Oh, so that when people see me, they don't see me, but they see you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody shout out. Hallelujah. So we must take advantage of the blood. And in that, I'm going to be through with this. We no longer live unto ourselves, but unto him which died for them and rose again.
Hallelujah.
That blood is powerful.
Yes, it is.
That blood gives us strength to rise from the dead.
Yes. That's his name.
You must understand that we dead to God when we in sin. Oh, but the blood gave us the strength to rise up in the name of Jesus. I don't hear nobody. Gave us power. Somebody shout power. If you trust in the blood, if you continue to die to sin, if you continue to die to your flesh, the more death you have, the more you die, the more power you have. Oh God, I'll raise you up. I don't give nobody. As I abase myself, as I come to nothing, as I deny myself, and I say God's gonna lift me up. Somebody shout yes. I'm not lifting me up. The way that I want to get lifted up. But he's gonna lift me up. And if he wants to lift me up, he's gonna use me. For his glory. Somebody shout yes. To the point that I can lay on hands. Lay hands on the sick. They shall recover. I don't know nobody. Somebody might come in messed up with devils. And I can cast out devils. In the name of Jesus. I'm in one. All those things. But we now know we are. Because I am the blood. But y'all better catch it.
Hallelujah.
This is a word.
Yes.
This is a teacher. So we must live unto God.
Oh, yes.
Do away with everything that you know that's not like Him.
Yes.
And live unto Him.
Yes.
It's not easy.
No.
It's a struggle.
Oh, yes.
It's hard. It's not easy. Brother Robert, was it hard to give up everything you gave up? Mm-mm. It was not easy. Come on, somebody. Minister Ingram, was it hard for you or easy for you to humble yourself before the mighty hand of God? Was it easy or hard? Come on, somebody. Brother Kenneth, was it easy for you? Come on now. To do everything that God tells you to do. I'm going to tell y'all right now, I stand here as your pastor. It's not easy. But one thing, the Apostle Paul said, I will press toward the mark for the prize. Y'all don't hear me. Come on, somebody. So it's up to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And He's telling you that it's time for us to live unto Him. Come on now. He gave His life for us. Somebody shout, blood seed.
Blood seed.
Now you need to let that thing be planted in good ground in your heart. And let it grow. And let God do everything that He wants to do in you. Come on, somebody. If it's anybody that feels like I do, don't repeat it right now. I'm going to say it first and then I'm going to give you the chance. But somebody can say, have your way in me, Lord. Is it anybody that feel that way? If you really feel that way, tell him, have your way with me, Lord. I want to be used by you. Thank you, Jesus. It ain't easy. So, Cherie, we fall down. But we get back up. Come on, somebody. And the devil can't hold us down. Because we get back up in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, yes, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Now somebody ought to be ready to stand up and tell God. Hallelujah. Have your way in me. Have your way in me. And today all I've done for you is I've planted a seed. That's it. One plant, another waters, but God's going to give the increase. Matter of fact, you can water it yourself right now.
Somebody come back.
You can water it yourself right now. By accepting and receiving His word with gladness. Somebody praise Him for His word. Is going to do something in you. If you're willing and you're ready to allow Him, He's going to do something in you. But don't be fooled. Because when we get the word of God and when God starts blessing, the devil starts messing. And the Bible says He can transform Himself into an angel of light. To where He looks like God, sounds like God. If He can't stop you, He's going to try to push you overboard. Come on, somebody. He will plant a seed in you to make you think you're going the right way.
Yes, He will.
when in fact you're going the wrong way.
All messed up.
Because there's an order to everything.
Oh, yes, it is.
Y'all, I know I didn't preach like I usually do, but have I preached today? Did y'all get something?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But it's time for us to accept everything that God has for us.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. One more time. Have your way, Lord. Did you mean it? Now, I can't judge you, but if I were to judge you, I would say that some of you didn't sound convincing.
Yeah. Have your way, Lord. Have your way.
Hallelujah.
Have your way, Lord.
But God's looking at your heart.
Oh, yes.
Somebody tell him, have your way, Lord. Come on, give God some praise. Get up on your feet. Get up out of here. Get up on your feet. Give God some praise. And tell him, have your way. Do what you want to do, Lord. Have your way. Come on, clap your hands. Have your way, Lord. Have your way. Come on, somebody. Have your way. Come on, praise him.
Thank you.
to try Jesus. To accept him into your heart. Let him do what he wants to do with you. To be reclaimed, to be restored, to re-penetrate your life. We want you to come forward. Will there be one? Will there be one? The offering took a little while, so I hope y'all don't mind me taking a while with this. Come on, somebody. Because your soul is important. More important than anything. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody ought to be praising God right now. And say the angels in heaven are rejoicing. Over the world. And the simple thing is knowing that Jesus died and rose again. It's in the history books. And because he did it for us, for you and for me. And we know that all of us are born into sin and shaped in iniquity. And because of that fact, we all need to be born again. And the Bible declares that that which is born of flesh is flesh. But that which is born of spirit is spirit. So we need to be born again unto God. Because the Bible says he died for us. And now it's time for us to live unto him. And I praise God for the two of you. So knowing this, that he died for our sins and he rose again, do you believe that? And because we believe that, oh, hallelujah, we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart. Just tell somebody, I believe it. I believe it. Tell somebody, I believe it. I believe it. Then it says, we shall be saved. So in this, salvation has come.
Hallelujah.
But you have to know that salvation also is not just one confession. But salvation is a way of life. And from what you all are talking about, I know what you're ready.
Yes, sir.
And that has blessed my heart, my soul today.
Yes.
It's a way of life. Yes. We change our way of living. We change our way of doing things. We change everything to fit the Bible, to fit God, to fit his word. Amen? Yes. Glory to God. So in that we ask God, save me. Y'all, I said, man, we took all of them, baby. Y'all can say, one man, save me, Jesus. Forgive me, Jesus. I'm a sinner, and I need to be saved. Save me, Jesus. Save me, Jesus. And Lord, we thank you for these two blessed souls today. Touch this precious woman from the crown of the head to the soles of her feet. You know everything she needs. You know everything about her. And we want you to bless her, God. Give her what she needs. Meet her needs. She's yours now. And you promise to supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. Bless this precious woman in Jesus' name. Lord, bless this precious, awesome man of God, yours. In the name of Jesus, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, give him everything he needs. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, and I pray that you let it be a blessed union. In the name of Jesus. Guard your way in the name of Jesus. In every area, you're God and be God over their lives. And we thank you for them right now. We got another brother and another sister. God bless you, my brother. Come on, somebody, y'all. Hallelujah. And since you told me I don't know if you took their names already. God, and we thank God for you. Somebody give God praise for you. Hallelujah. There may be some that need prayer. And we are going to. Amen. Anoint these leaders. Huh? They got three babies too. Woo! Yeah, that's right. Hallelujah. Five. Woo! We all got a bunch of kids. Well, I got about 12 of them. Y'all don't hear that. They got what? All right. And they want to be baptized. Amen. Oh my God. Thank you. All right. And listen. We're going to put it. Listen. Let's get this together, Sister Toya. Set it up. Let's do it. I've said it over and over again. But we got to come together. And I'm trying.